it worked.
You beat him?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, dude.
Yeah. Yeah, look. Look at what the position was.
Let me see what it was. You were checking him every way. Oh, yeah, that's a beautiful position.
Oh, my God, dude. He beat him.
Man, that was fabulous.
Thank you. Depending on how much people trash talk me, that's gonna be my feisty one.
Oh, okay. Well, don't get feisty with them then.
You know,
to give it to them.
You know, I had to go full feisty on Carlini. He was scared.
You had to go full feisty on Carlini.
You needed to come to your mommy, didn't
you? Uh huh. Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, get it. What happened? Who did what? That's not nice.
Can't let that pawn go any further. It will be a big difference in the game.
Say.
You know what?
What happened?
It's never bad to move. It's not always bad to move things back. See, I've got a game plan. I've got a game
plan. Yeah. I would definitely sell that.
Wait. You
see.
I see you're a positional little one. You're a positional little one.
What happened?
You're a very positional guy.
I am?
Yeah.
Me?
You know what?
Me?
I'm gonna go positional. It's time for attacking. Look at that slicer.
I see that slicer. He's a slicer. I see it. Slicer, I'm going to get out of your way because you're a slicer.
You know, I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm sorry. Now my bishop becomes a slicer. There's nothing. My bishop's got nothing to have a deal with. Hello, Brian.
No question.
Pizza slicers. I like my pieces.
You like your pieces? I like your pieces too.
Okay. Well, I need to make something else a slicer. We got too many defenders. Two is not enough.
What happened? Who did what? You're slicing. You're slicing and dicing.
I'm going to have to go outpost.
Outpost?
Outpost. Rook on, pinging on the seven.
The rook is pinging on the whoop-de-wop-de, whoop-de-wop-de.
Yeah.
I did see the whoop-de-wop-de.
You know what? I'm squeezing.
I won't know till you tell me.
You're in a little bit of a fishy situation.
Fishy?
Yeah, in like a weird situation.
A weird situation, like fishy.
What?
They said that there was light at the end of the tunnel. But you know what? They never told us it was a train.
You know what?
Who did what? I won't know till you tell me. What are you doing? You would do me like that? After all we've been through? After all we've been through, you would do me like that?
You know, I'm gonna have to go full feisty because you've been trash talking me and hustling me like that.
Hustle? Who did what? Shame on you. After all we've been through, you would do me like that?
I just picked the wrong piece by accident.
You picked up the wrong piece by accident.
I did. But you know what?
I won't know till you tell me.
I'm a gangster.
You're a gangster?
I'm a gangster.
You're a gangster.
Gangster. I know where your little fishy song
is. Who did? Wait a minute. After all we've been through, you would do me that way? Let me get him out of here. They said that there was light at the end of the tunnel. But you know what they never told us? Huh? They didn't tell us it was a train.
Yeah, that's the first thing that's getting the motherfucker. Why don't you take it? Why don't you take it home? They're pretty. You're not good
at those rides. Huh? Who did what?
Oh, thank you, Brian.
You gave me that? Oh, I missed. I must have missed something.
I'm knocking that pawn off.
You're knocking that pawn off. Don't do that. Whatever you do. Who did what?
Yeah, I did.
What happened?
It's you.
Not you.
If people upset me, I go full feisty.
Full feisty? Like nicety?
Yeah.
So how long did you play here?
Morris, you might lose.
He would never lose, not against me. He's too good. Wait a minute.
You better not say, the next time you say I lose, you're going to lose.
Wait a minute, who did what? Watch out, hold on, wait a minute. Be nice. Just be nice.
Why are you even talking to a player like me? You're a player.
You're too good, man. I don't know. They said that there was light at the end of the tunnel, but guess what they never told us?
That it was a train.
That it was a train. You understand. As long as you understand, we're going to be all right. Hmm?
But why is knowing that it's a train important?
Why is knowing that it's a train important? Who did what? They said that there was light at the end of the tunnel, but what didn't they tell us? What's the light?
That there was no... That there was
what is the light? You got to tell me what the light is. What's the light? A train. That's all the light is. A light is a train. Who did what? Did you do that?
I did that.
You did that?
I did it.
Let me get out your way.
Okay. I did
it. Hold on, let me get that baby. You mind if I get that?
I did it.
You did that.
I did it.
You did that.
I'm a feisty little one.
You are feisty. Like iced tea.
Morris, are you going to go Big Daddy mode?
You want to see it? You must do it. There goes your night. I'm hungry. I want
you. Indeed, you are.
I get one will promote.
Doing there? Oh, you got crazy with me, didn't you?
Ryan told me to do that. Look, your knight is dead.
Dead? It's fried fish. Dead is fried fish. You know what fried fish is?
Yeah.
It's dead.
Literally, your knight is just stuck.
What happened to him? Well, take him off my hands. He's been a bad boy. You know that? Where's my light been? Oh. Wait a minute. Why are you being so nasty to my knight?
I'm being feisty to your knight.
You being feisty?
Not nasty.
Yes, sir. Wait a minute. Why are you being so mean to my piece?
Okay, you're a feisty little one. You're point two feisty. Stop taking my name.
Point two feisty.
No. Don't say you're point two. I don't want to hear any lies, little boy.
Ooh. Whoa. Wait a minute.
Whoa. He's learning trash talk.
Shame on you. Shame on you.
I'm hungry. You better give me the promotion. Give me. Wait.
Who did what? Wait a minute. Why are you so mean to me?
I am being mean.
You are being
mean. Because you've been mean to me. Give me that. Where's that?
Oh my goodness.
I'm hungry.
You are. Why are you so mean to me? Why are you so mean to me? I just want to know why you're so mean to me.
Mate.
Wait. Are you sure?
Almost. Stop.
Why are you so mean to me?
Stop. You're touching my pieces.
I am.
Queen,
he's trying to get on time.
Wait a minute, what is that? Oh, your time is up! What happened? Young killer, what happened? open. I don't know, wow. Young Killer.
Right, the time was up.
Young Killer, what happened? You're too feisty.
That's insane.
Good game.
Young Killer, how did you do that?
I wanted to play you.
Hey guys, Brent here. What a thrilling finish between Rick and Forrest here. And Forrest, this was a pawn, so I think that's why Rick moved here. But if it was a queen, I don't think he would have moved. So Forrest could have taken the king and won, but he was just scrambling under time pressure. And it was just absolutely crazy. And some crazy things happened in the time scramble that I'm sure you guys have questions on. Going over here, I think in the game, Rick's when he moved the piece, his king fell like sideways. So he picked it back up and then accidentally put it here. And I think Forrest, a couple moves later, you know, they were kind of jockeying for position here. And then I think Forrest accidentally, he moved here and then he moved here. He thought it was his turn. So he moved twice. So stuff like that can happen in a blitz game. It's totally normal. It's to be expected. But just, wow, what a crazy game by both and very, very positional. And this was a tough choice because, and I think both players make good decisions in this endgame. By the way, it ended in the draw because I think White didn't have mating material, right? And he lost on, and he won on time. So that is a draw. But I think Rick played this very well in the endgame, especially here in this position. You know, if he, instead of playing king up, if he takes, he makes it way too easy for Forrest. So at this point, Rick knows that he's losing on the board. So his only hope is to win on time. And you do that by making it tough for your opponent, kind of wasting your opponent's moves here, right? And then hiding behind these two pawns here. So Rick doing a great job of being aware of time. And I think for Forrest, he has a tough decision because he's under time pressure. Does he go for the mate? Or does he gobble up the pieces so at least he secures the draw? And there was mating opportunities for Forrest, but as you soon see, they all rely on square control, which you don't really have time to calculate doing it, you know, when you're still low on time pressure. So we'll go over what those mates were, but real quick, I'm going to go here all the way back here in this position and highlight a couple things. By the way, both played a really great positional game. And I think here in this position in the game, F6, this was like the first available tactic that was missed. Let's go move back. We'll be another move for black here. And by the way, you gotta love the banter between these two, man. So it's like Rick being a chess uncle, you know, that fun chess uncle, and Forrest just loving every minute of it. So that's really cool to see. Yes, the move was bishop f5, and now boom, look at these. And I love how Forrest calls them slicers. This rook has nowhere to hide. What are you gonna do? And black will be winning. And going over here, I love how Forrest kind of calculated this initially. This looks like a good move by Rick, right? But boom, unveils the discovered check, discovered attack with the check, and black is winning. So that was a very, very nice kind of subtle trap set up by Forrest. Very impressive there. Going over here real quick, let's go over some of the mates that Forrest missed. End game, we had bishop e5. Let's go move back. Will be another move for black here. And I gave you a hint. It's all about square control. Yes, what are white's exits here? You know, white only has boom, boom. Everything else is covered. So how do you block these two squares of escape? Yes, move the king up, boom, and nothing white can do, and this will be checkmate. You either have it with the pawn or the queen, but the pawn is much prettier. And here in this position, queen check was played. Let's go move back. Will be another move for white, or for black here. Yes, queen c4 check, and again, square control, boom, 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 only available here, and checkmate. Going over here in the game, queen takes this play, let's go move back. You guys see it? I'll give you a hint, it's a slicer mate. Yes, bishop f6 checkmate. But again, those are very, very hard to calculate. You got, that's, you know, when you have a lot of time, you can calculate the square control mates there, but not when you're running low on time. But fantastic game played by Rick and Forrest. Gotta love the banter and the whole train, the train joke by Rick. That was funny too. Very, very funny game and just a wild, thrilling finish there at the end with a couple kind of mistakes. But That's what happens when the pieces get knocked over and stuff. But nicely done, Rick, for the draw, and great fight by Forrest, man. That was a nice endgame conversion. Just the time was ticking, man, and it's not easy when you're the one playing. Nicely done, boys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know if you thought of the game comments below. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell for kitchen. Thanks. We'll see you guys tomorrow.